In this quick Photoshop tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the elliptical marquee tool or the circular marquee tool to make different types of selections and to make a cutout. And this is from one of my tutorials that actually appears inside the Photoshop app itself. Let me show you how to find the image. So when you're inside of Photoshop, click the little magnifying glass and this will take you to the Discover panel. Under the Discover panel, you'll see there's some hands-on tutorials. And I was selected by Adobe to actually create some of these that live inside the app. And my ones live under the selector mask. And if you actually look at these last one, two, three, four, five, these five are all created by me. The one we're doing today is this one. So if we click on that and choose Start Tutorial, what it's going to do is it's going to open it up and it's going to give you some guided instructions that you can follow along step by step. But it also gives you the layered file. So you can use this layered file and follow along with this video if you choose. So let's jump in right now. And what we're gonna do is cut out a elliptical shape here and allow the water to show through into this conference table. So the first thing we wanna do is choose the elliptical marquee tool. So under the marquee tool, hold it down and you'll get the ellipse. Now I want to give you some tips on working with the ellipse, which is really the main gist of this particular tutorial, because this can be a difficult tool to work with. You know, you're trying to line it up and, you know, of course I'm going to get it pretty good, but you know, you try to do that and you're like, not quite, go down a little, oh, too low. How many of you guys have ever struggled with this? Particularly when you first started. Actually, that was pretty good. Look at that. Pretty bang on. All right. So let me give you some tips. So if you're drawing a circle with the elliptical tool, if you hold down the shift key, this will constrain it to a perfect circle. If you release it, you get an oval. If you hold down the alt key or the option key, and let me just start again, you'll actually draw from the center. See how it's coming out from the center and instead of coming out from the corner. See, there's the corner. Alt or option key goes from the center. And if you also hold down shift, we can do a perfect circle from the center. Now, if you want to draw or move this around while you're creating it, we're still holding down that mouse button. Hold the space bar. And with the space bar, we can reposition. So you could actually just create your ellipse and reposition it using that space bar tool. See what I'm doing here? And it's pretty close. However, notice how it needs to rotate a little bit. Now, how do you rotate this? Well, let me show you. We're going to create an ellipse and I'm just going to release. And this is another tool which is just very, very powerful. And if we go under the select menu, which is all our selections live under here, and then we're going to choose transform selection. What it does is it brings up the bounding boxes just like any other transformation. And we can simply drag it into position. Grab the edge. See how we're choosing that edge? Now, if you want to do both at the same time, hold down the Alt or the Option key, and that will mirror our adjustment. See that? So I'm just dragging it down. I can do the top or bottom. Alt or Option will do both at the same time. And let's drag the bottom and see what I'm doing. We can just align it that way. Now, the nice thing about using this tool is you can also rotate. And to rotate, just go out to the corner, see how we get that little arrow there. And so essentially this makes it very, very easy to click and drag and move our selection around and get it exactly as we want. Let me just nudge it up a little bit. That's not bad. Now to apply that selection, hit the enter key or the check mark at the top. Now what we want to do is we want to cut out this area of the table and show the water underneath, just in that area. Now, if I go to create a layer mask, what it's going to do is the layer mask, well, let me just show you, it's going to do the opposite of what we want. See how that's the opposite? So to create a layer mask where the selected area is cut out and everything else is visible, so an inverted, what you're going to do is hold down the Alt or the Option key, click on the new layer mask, and that will create an inverted layer. And you can see now we're able to see the water going through the conference table. Pretty simple, but I wanted to give you those tips for making elliptical or circular selections because they can be so tricky, particularly when people are, getting started. So anyway, guys, let me know in the comments, did you find this simple tutorial useful? Did you learn anything new, any new tips or anything like that? And also let me know in the comments, what would you like to see me do in the next tutorial? And by the way, guys, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit that subscribe button and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And do me a favor, hit that like button. What it does is it helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.